Hi guys! In this tutorial, I'm going to talk about the new Steam feature. So as you can see, I made a terrible shirt, I messed it all up, so we have all these ugly lines, made one side taller than the other, all the things you shouldn't do, big armholes, etc. So we can see how to use the Steam feature to iron out these lumps. So this is the Steam tool. If you click on it, then you'll get different options here. So size just makes your brush bigger or smaller. And hardness defines how hard the edge of your brush is, similar to what you have in Photoshop. So if you make the hardness higher, you'll have a very hard edge to your stroke. And if you lower the hardness, you're going to have a much softer edge. You can see it's much more blurry. So I'll go with about a hardness of 50. And let's get rid of these wrinkles here. To use the tool, simply brush over holding down your left mouse button and then simulate to see the effect. You can brush over it several times if you need for a stronger effect. And you see when I brush over it a few times, it gets a darker blue. Now let's do this side too. And there you can see those ugly wrinkles are disappearing. Now, personally, I would never use the Steam feature to do what I just showed you right now, because it's not really getting rid of the wrinkles. Well, it looks like that, but what it's really doing actually is just making the shirt extremely tight. You'll see it in a moment. There we go. Instead of fixing the issue, it just sort of tightened it until the wrinkles are no longer visible. So although it's positioned as a tool to get rid of ugly wrinkles, and it would appear that it does that, it's really not a good solution if you have problems like this. You should just tend to your sewing and fix up the problems instead of just making it so tight. As you can see here in the front, it flattened out the wrinkles, but it made it so tight that the buttons are just tearing right off. And here the same thing on the sleeve. If I wanted to get rid of these wrinkles here and would paint on it, it would get rid of the wrinkles, but it would make also the sleeve very, very tight. And there you can see all the parts where we smoothed out the wrinkles are red, are really tight. So let's look at the other options and what one can do with this tool. Now maybe if you have a few small wrinkles that no matter what you do, you just can't get rid of them, maybe it would be useful to use a Steam tool. But honestly, if there are some wrinkles that are looking ugly, there's a reason for that, and that's because you didn't do the sewing right, or one length is longer than the other, or there's some other kind of a problem that you should tend to instead of just sort of trying to fake it away. So let's take a look at what else one can do with the Steam feature. Here I have a very loose shirt, big, baggy, ugly thing. And let's say instead of elastic to take in this part here, let's see how we can do it with the Steam feature. Now if we would do it with elastic, let me just show you the effect we'd have. You know, gathers up here. And if we wanted to only do elastic on a small part, we'd have to put a segment point there. And then turn on elastic only on that part. And we can get those gathers there. Now we can do the same thing with the steaming. Let's get rid of this point here and take the steam. So if we take it into the plus percentage, you see we get this red bar. And if we take it into the minus, it's going to shrink it. It's going to gather it together and going to make it tighter. Let's just simulate a second to straighten that out. And let's decrease the size. Right? Let's pause the simulation and make it a bit more dramatic so we can see it. And I'll just paint here some blueness. Simulate. It's a bit hard to see. Let's reduce the particle distance a bit so we can see the gathers more clearly. There you can see we've got these bunching up gathers. Can zoom in closer. And let's just remove all steam and come in with an even smaller brush. So we're just gonna brush along the edge here and then simulate. And there you can see the gathers are now starting a bit higher. Before there was like this space before they started. So there we made these gathers. Now let's see what else we can do. If we move all steam, take a bigger brush and increase the minus shrinkage so it's gonna gather even stronger to simulate. So instead of running an elastic band around her waist, let's see how we can do that with steam. I'm going to make my brush a bit smaller, increase the hardness a bit, and make a line across the center and then simulate. And there, as you can see, it's almost like an elastic band effect. It gathered it up. And we can also do the same thing in the back. And on the back, I'm going to decrease the hardness a lot, so it's very, very soft, with a very soft edge. And also let's take down the particle distance in the back pattern. And here we can see, because it was a hard edge in the front, the wrinkles are very defined where they start. But in the back, it's much softer. You don't really see exactly where they're starting. It's sort of smudgy almost. And you can see here in the center, where it doesn't quite meet up, there's like this sort of empty space without gathers. I'm going to run one more time over them, up to the center here, and like that. And then we can see it's much more intense and it's really pulling it together really tight. You can hear my computer groaning unhappily. Now we can do the same thing here. We can make some gathers here too. In the back. So you could use that to make local gathers where you want to make them. Instead of using elastic, it's an option. And also on this shirt, if we remove all steam, we'll be able to see the effect of the plush shrinkage nicely. Let's raise that to something really dramatic that will be easy to see. And just make a big lump here. So as you can see, it's sort of like inflating it. And the other one was sort of deflating it, pinching together. And this is sort of bloating it out. For instance, if you wanted to make a gather here, you could just brush along here. And there we've got a shirt up there with this gathering. If you take this in a bit, not to be so wide, put a point here, you can start to get some kind of a design of a shirt. So that's just some ideas of how you can use a steam brush. I still prefer to use elastic lines really to control things the way I want to, but this is nice because you can have the kind of effect that you can't have with thin elastic lines. So for instance, if I just made an elastic line, you know, it's this thin kind of elastic gather. Now if you wanted to make it a bit thicker, looking like an elastic band, not just a thin strip, you'd have to copy and paste it and then, you know, you still have some things gathering in the middle there. So the steam feature can be useful. And there you've got a smooth area where you could put some texture on top or a different layer, a belt. And you have the gathers coming out, not just the gathers from one thin line, like with elastic line. And if you find some other uses for the steam feature, please let me know in the comments. Alright, so I'll see you in the next tutorial.